So I want to start off this video with this disclaimer that me talking about Little Big Planet for the PS3, I will really never be accurate about Little Big Planet, just because the evolving nature of the game, which is a simple platforming game at its core, but it's a title that focuses on sharing user-generated content. With each day that comes to pass, LBP becomes bigger, more complicated, and more different, especially with patches and downloadable content. In fact, it's only been about, after 2 months since the game's release, it's already become really different. When LBP Little Big Planet first came out, the community had quite a number of things to complain about, such as lack of quality levels, user levels, serious server issues and lags, which is still kind of there, but a lot of it has kind of fixed and there's a lot of different solutions now. There was an absence of a search engine, there was no search engine at all, and downloadable content was largely unimportant. It was just character skins, stuff like that. But in just 2 months, after 2 months of its release, all of that changed. You know, there were a number of user levels to experiences now well over, after 2 months, was hundreds of thousands. Now it's over 1.8 million or something like that. 1.8 million levels to experience, all of which can be played on the recently to be released Little Big Planet 2. Anyway, the server issues are less frequent. There's been kind of new solutions around around lag issues and stuff of that nature, and connection issues. There has been a new search engine that's been implemented, and the search engine, it's also been refined over time. After 2 months, it's been released. After 4 months, there was a patch that really made the search engine more usable and more, able to seek out the levels that you wanted to seek out, and the better community features. And also, Little Big Planet Store was implemented into the game. A Little Big Store was implemented into the game, bringing in new elements of the game, new downloadable content that even brought new elements of the gameplay, such as the Metal Gear Solid downloadable content, which added new paint gun. So, it's a game that's constantly evolving, constantly improving, or not improving or changing for the worse. But the fact of the matter is, the criticism I may have or the praise I may have for LBP today may not exist tomorrow. And that's the nature of Little Big Planet. It's constantly evolving, constantly changing. It's really a game that you grow with time. It grows with time. But in any case, let's start just by saying, But what if you're not the type of gamer that really likes creating levels or sharing levels? You know, you just want to play a game. What about that? Well, see, the ability to create levels is not available until you beat the first story levels. These levels are very basic training, teaching you the fundamental gameplay aspects of the game, which just include grabbing, jumping, physics-based puzzles, and posting stickers and decorations. That's pretty much the entire gameplay mechanics of the game. After these introductory levels, the game begins to show its imaginative side. If anyone is worried that the simple platform mechanics of the game would prevent this game from being involving or complex, rest assured, the 25 story levels and the 25 party levels in this game are really pretty amazing. They're mind-blowing, at least to me, and offer tons and tons of fun. There are different themes to each level, and each level takes place in a familiar continent. The first introductory levels are set up in Europe. After that, players are taking the levels in Africa, creepy South America, urban Northeastern America, Oriental Far Eastern Asia, mythical Central Asia, and finally the bone-chilling Russia. Aside from these simple themes, the story levels in this game require more than jumping and grabbing. There are dog-like beasts to guide, a wheel of death to overcome, mine cars to direct amidst passive flame and exploding barrels, and dangerous hallucinations to avoid. Simply put, the story levels in LBP are not at all limited by the simplistic control schemes of the game. Even though all the gameplay controls are required in this game is the analog jump button, pop it button, and the grab button, the level design in this game requires players to do far, far more than that. What's more compelling about the story levels is the fact that there are hidden collectibles all over the place. These things, once obtained, can be used to customize the appearance of the player's sack boy or the sack girl, you know, what the current characters are called in the game. And you can use them to decorate levels, or actually use as objects in the levels you come to create. Some can only be obtained by cooperating with other players, and some can only be obtained by other collected items. Trying to collect them all can be an obsession, but more importantly, it will lead players to level design that must be experienced by all gamers of all ages. Even if you don't have an internet connection and have no desire to share or create levels, the story levels featured in this game are really well worth checking out. Of course, keep in mind that some aspects of the story levels can be frustrating because some parts can be just kind of difficult, like the Wheel of Death in the bunker level. And because the utilization of the three-dimensional planes can be a bit confusing, some parts that require cooperation among multiple players was really poorly designed, and the option to make checkpoints have infinite spawns for less skilled players would have been a nice addition. Also, when playing with other players, the screen zooms out the more as the players get separated from each other. So if you're playing with another player, and you guys both kind of just go in the opposite direction, the screen zooms out, right? But it just automatically decides to focus on one character, and the other, if it goes too far out, there is no way of knowing which characters would be focused by the game. So I thought that was just really odd design choice, and it was kind of frustrating in a way when you join in a lot of those match levels with vehicles, with fast moving vehicles, because once you start the vehicle, one character would just pop out of the way before the other characters could pop, ride the vehicle too. And in that case, you have no idea which character the camera is going to focus on. It's going to focus on the guy that's here, or it's going to focus on the guy that's there. Either way, if it focuses on the guy here, this guy dies. If it focuses on the guy here, that guy dies. It's just a really... They could have done a better implementation, such as the camera always focuses on the first character. But anyway, that's me nitpicking. Even if LBP did not give players the ability to create and share their levels, I would still recommend Little Big Planet to everyone, because it's just the story levels in this game are pretty amazing. But of course, the story levels are just the beginning. This game really features endless contents of fun and just more fun. Once you collected enough stickers, costumes, skins, and objects, and gone through all the creation tutorials, you're ready to create your own level. There are a lot of stuff to get used to, from learning how to operate pistons and sliding up switches, to controlling the camera angle, to directing how the lighting affects the level. Everything down to incorporating a picture of yourself via the PlayStation Eye, and down to implementing the music of the game in certain parts of the level is really customizable. The creation tool, while not limitless, is expansive and for the most part can bring to life whatever you want to bring to life. At first it's a bit intimidating, and it still is to me, but it's intimidating to come to a blank canvas and ask to make whatever you want, but learning how to create levels is actually really fun and involving. A lot of time and effort is required, but the end result is a community that never ever stops becoming fun. The creation tool would have been even more best if it allowed players to utilize custom soundtracks saved onto their PS3 hard drive. But nonetheless, what LBP offers to gaming consoles is a total revolution. New levels are being made every day, every single day by the community. There are all kinds of levels, from an exact replica of Space Invaders, yeah, even the control scheme is replicated, to an LBP version of basketball, to boss battle requiring players to fly around with swords while trying to dodge vortex projectiles. I mean, the creativity of this game is truly something to behold. Some of these people have never modded a level in their lives, and a lot of these people are not experienced at all in programming, and yet, they're able to create masterpieces of fun. Creation has, like, for the first time in gaming history, have become accessible and actually fun. I mean, there's Gary's Mod, but I feel like Gary's Mod is really something like, level modders are really get into, but just lay people, like lay gamers, given this creation tool, are able to become level creators. I think that's the most remarkable thing about Little Big Planet. At the time being, the ability to cooperatively create levels online has not been patched in. That's one of the things that I really, really was expecting to happen for Little Big Planet. To go online, to find, to invite a friend or to join in someone's pod and be like, hey, let's create a level together online. I think this would have been amazing. I mean, especially if you come across someone who makes amazing levels, to join their pod and to learn from them and to share kind of how to create levels, share creativity. And cooperatively create levels. You can cooperatively create levels offline, but not online. I think that is just missed opportunity there. And I'm hoping Little Big Planet 2 has that feature. I'm not sure if it does, but that would have been amazing. But in either case, the community of Little Big Planet is an amazing one. Even when people you encounter don't have a headset to talk to you, the game supports a typing system, even without a keyboard. And thus, communication is still available to all. Since the game encourages cooperation in the levels, it's very easy to find players who are friendly and helpful. In my playtime with Little Big Planet, I really found it hard to find Little Big Planet players that are jerks. In a lot of online competitive games, you know, you'll end up with just a lot of assholes online. But Little Big Planet, it was always fun to play with people, to me. The only frustrating time is when, I would really feel sorry if I was playing horribly and I would die a lot, you know, and that would really set the other player back. Or if the other player was just a really horrible player and just stayed in the same spot and didn't move, you know, that can be a little frustrating. But other than that, you know, it was really hard to encounter assholes on Little Big Planet just because of the cooperative nature of the game. You really the camera zooms out if the characters are too far apart, so it really encourages cooperation. I think that's really why it was really hard to find assholes on Little Big Planet online. There's also a system in Little Big Planet to rate and tag the levels you played. The rating is out of 5 stars, and tagging is done by selecting various words scattered on the page, whether they can be like boring, brilliant, or a simple tag of vehicle or platformer or whatever. It probably would have been really nicer to allow gamers to come up with their own words for tagging, or to be like to write something in. But I guess what's here kind of works. But that would have been awesome if I can type in whatever. It'd just be like this ingenious or kind of come up with my own words to describe the levels. There's also an option to heart levels and the level authors and the level of the authors. There's also an option to heart levels and the author of those levels, so you can heart them. And once hearted, these levels creator will be saved in your account so that you can revisit them. In the recently implemented search engine, you can now search based on amount of hearts, on ratings, on tags, on what you actually type out. It's a very intuitive search engine, and it's hard to imagine how it can be better than what it is currently. But the thing is, though, with the heart system, you know, a lot of people, because of the trophies, you know, you get a trophy depending on how many times you got hearted, how many times you hearted someone. You know, people have started this policy of, like, you heart me, I heart you back. That really kind of just really made good quality levels hard to find. Just because, you know, if you're just hearting for the sake of hearting, then what gets the most hearted are levels that give you trophies. Like, oh, you can get 8 trophies in this one level. And it's that kind of really just kind of broke the system a lot. But just really seeking out good levels is going to be rewarding, though, even with this problem. But there is that problem with the heart system. Currently, there are still a few issues when it comes to creating and sharing levels. As mentioned, the ability to cooperatively create levels is not available. There are still some instances of lags and disconnects, even to this day in 2010. I haven't played in 2011, but last time I played it was December. Early December 2010. I played this amazing Titanic level, like a recreation of Titanic, and it's like a museum. It was amazing, but there's still connection issues, there's still lag issues. Not as much as it was originally, but the loading time is shortened, but there is still that. So that's pretty much all I have to say. When I first got Little Big Planet, there was this issue of censorship for Media Molecule, but it really affected 5% of the entire Little Big Planet community. But the way Media Molecule handled the situation was just really poorly done. Like, they would just delete the levels and, not even give you warning, and the levels would be gone forever. And there was that issue, but that issue is over now. Like I said, Little Big Planet is a continually evolving game. The issues that I have with it today may not be the issues I have with tomorrow. Unless, of course, the issue is that, oh, I hate the physics of the game, the floaty controls or whatever. If you hate that, then that's probably an issue that you're going to have with this game forever. Even with Little Big Planet 2, I've read that its physics hasn't changed. Now, I never really had a problem with that. I actually really like the physics just because it's realistic nature of it. That's that. So, I think Little Big Planet is definitely one of the most important titles for the industry as a whole. The imagining side of the story levels are one thing, but the ability to create any kind of level and share it online and play with three other offline or online players is a really remarkable feat. There's some tiny issues in the gameplay department, like the awkward co-op screen adjustment, the confusing three-dimensional platforming. It's kind of sometimes confusing to go to the back layer, to the middle, and the forefront. But those nitpickings aside, it is really a hallmark in the industry, and it's a game to provoke your creative side, and a game to make creating and editing actually fun and accessible to all. And I just can't wait to get my hands on the sequel, Little Big Planet 2.